day. On June the 6th, 1944, an Allied expeditionary force will invade the continent of Europe. That day must come. In January of 1943, the Allies commit themselves to the liberation of Europe while their soldiers, sailors, and airmen storm the gates of Tripoli. North Africa is yet to be won, but the combined chiefs of staff speak their distant dream to cross the channel, return to the continent. The chiefs of state christen this supreme operation with a noble code name, Overlord. In London, a year later, the Supreme Commander, Allied Expeditionary Forces, General Eisenhower, takes up the task of piercing the heart of Germany and destroying her armed forces. But across the narrow English Channel lies the ultimate barrier, Hitler's Atlantic Wall, formidable guardian of Festung Europa, the fortress of Europe. Marshal Rommel, the Desert Fox, one-time hero of the Africa Corps, commands the coastal defense. He multiplies the fortifications and sows death on the beaches for those who dare transgress. But there is no roof on the fortress of Europe, and assault from the sky begins long months before the day called D. This is the key that unlocks the gate. Paralyze Germany's war machine. Pound the Luftwaffe into impotence. The troops, the men who must finish what the bombers have begun. Each month, the United States pours 150,000 of her young men onto the British Isles. All England becomes an armed camp, one vast depot of armament and supplies. Hour, a torrent of materiel and men will be set in motion, southward to the channel, southward to the embarkation ports, southward to destiny. Thank you. It is spring, 1944. The date has been set. The hour has been chosen. Men committed to the assault are sealed in ships for secrecy. Forts, camps, and assembly points are cut off from the outside world. There is nothing to do but wait on tide and weather. Wait and get ready and keep ready. And wait and wait. Ships depart. From different ports, the ships sail at varying intervals to arrive at the five landing beaches together. Five beaches stretched 60 miles over the coast of France. Their mission is to support the landings. Intelligence officers have warned the Supreme Commander that the airborne assault is too hazardous to succeed. But without it, the landings may fail. Eisenhower faces a crucial decision. Should he risk the slaughter of two superb divisions, or should he cancel the drop and imperil the whole invasion? He orders the paratroopers to France. Fly 5,000 sorties to support the amphibious assault. Ships will converge on France with the precision of a dress parade. The Luftwaffe has been broken. The U-boats driven from the channel. The vanguard of 35 divisions moves unmolested toward the beaches. Warships prepare to open the assault with a barrage of gunfire. Battleship Nevada is there, torpedoed at Pearl Harbor, a flagship at Normandy. Naval guns open the Western Front. Inside Hitler's Atlantic Wall, the Nazis know what the world does not. The assault is on. Defeated in the north. Defeated in the south. Defeated in the east. The Germans have but one hope left. Destroy the invaders from the west.